the steel. They have commissioned everything. 10 million tons. It's not a joke. If you see Tata's, they have been around for 70, 100 years, and they are at 7 million. We are at 10 million. This gives you a comparative. All kudos to the team.
It has been the vision of the promoter directors. They saw the larger picture. I think the timing has been right. We have the entire 10 million ton facility up and running.
Achieving the goal of reaching to 10 million ton steel plant status has been really a very challenging task. I would think so many things come to my mind, but primarily it's that positive attitude, which is, you know, always promoted by our promoter directors, which is built on the pillars of passion to start with, progress and people.
SR Steel started its journey by producing 0.4 million tons per annum of hot briquette iron. Today, SR Steel is the fourth largest producer of flat products in India. It has commissioned its 10 MTPA plant at Hazira, Gujarat.
The creation of the steel complex in Hazira has enabled SR Steel to evolve as one of the leading steel producers globally. We can be proud of several milestones and achievements, from being the first HBI DRI producer in India to being the largest HBI DRI facility in the world. We are also the lowest emitter of greenhouse gases in the Indian steel industry. The SR Steel Hazira complex has announced the doubling of its capacity to 10 MTPA. This expansion makes the Hazira Steel Complex the largest single-location flat steel producer in India and the fourth largest single-location flat steel producer globally. With this expansion, the complex will be able to offer the entire range of flat products, from thin strips and thick plates to pipes, cold rolled and coated products.
I feel very proud to be an SRite after commissioning of 10 MTPA. This is a great time for us.
This is a very great achievement, and I am very proud to be one of the members in this SR family in achieving this. Not many steel plants have achieved so fast. It's a very great achievement.
First and foremost, I thank and congratulate each one of the employees who were associated with this project, whether it is from the project group, whether it's from the operations group, whether it's from the finance group, whether it's from the procurement group. We had, whether it's from the land acquisition group, we had our share of troubles. Appreciate the finance group for having, you know, got the required funds to fund the project. They did a lovely good job. And the project team, you know, worked day and night to ensure that we have this world-class facility.
I remember the heads of the Department of Plate Mill, of the Blast Furnace, of the Corex, and of Steel Melting Shop 2, I mean, Konark and CSP. They were, though operational heads, but they jumped into the work of construction together with EPIL and worked as if they were construction engineers or project engineers, and they took the work from EPIL to some extent. That's okay, we'll come, you know, together with you to get our assets faster and better.
SR has adopted an integration and securitization strategy that has enabled it to keep its costs low even with the expanded capacity.
Achieving 10 MTPA required a lot of hard work, effort from all across up and down in the organization. So, I mean, it's a big achievement for us all, and I think we've done the company and the country proud by having this set up. Yeah, I think it's a huge implication for the country as well as the state, and especially for SR Steel. Basically, the expansion hinges around three aspects. One is that we've set up a plate mill, we've set up a CSP, and we set up the pipe mill. Obviously, at the back end of it, there's the entire steel making and the different process routes, as well as the pelletization expansion that has taken place. So, and this provides an absolutely diversified and versatile product range to SR. So, I mean, we're the only flat product producer which has the entire gamut. So, whether it's very thick, heavy plate to ultra thin gauge hot roll coil or cold roll or galvanized sheet. So, I mean, this is a one-stop shop, basically, so far as steel products on the flat side are concerned. We are the only producers who have this kind of range.
You know, we have all the three technologies today in Hazira. One is the HBI DRI, which is in the existing plant. And then we moved on to blast furnace iron-making technology, and then the Corex iron-making technology. HBI DRI is basically using gas as fuel, and instead of increasing our dependence on natural gas, very rightly we have moved away to coke and non-coking coal. The facilities that have been installed are absolutely world class. They are state of the art, and it also covers the entire spectrum of products.
SR Steel is one of the very few companies in the world to have all three modern technologies of iron making: blast furnace, Corex, and Midrex. SR Steel can proudly say it is the only company in India to have all three technologies under one roof.
From a customer perspective, they don't want to go for hot roll coil to one somebody and then cold roll to somebody, galvanized plates to a fourth person. They know if they're talking to SR Steel, they can provide the entire range. That is one thing. Then it's the entire competitiveness aspect also, because everything's happening at Hazira, there's no transport. A lot of the producers they're producing hot roll in one location, they're producing cold roll maybe 1,000 kilometers away. So there's no such thing over here. I mean, everything is happening next to each other. Transportation costs are minimized. You have your own port. That again is a big booster. Gujarat is the second largest consumer in the country, and the second largest in the West also. And then if you look at it, because of the port, it gives us the strength to go to all the nearby markets as well as on the coastal routes. So the Middle East becomes a natural extension for us.
We are doubling our, more than doubling our production capacity. Second, we are adding new products into our product basket. Thirdly, there will be a significant drop of cost of production. We will be one of the lowest cost producers in the world.
The other thing that we've done is set up the service center and distribution facilities. So with the service centers, which are 7 in number, spread across the length and breadth of the country, we have set up the capacities catering to auto clusters, large fabrication requirements, as well as a lot of engineering applications.
Gujarat. What is happening is, if you are in Gujarat, you are employing people. To give you a very simple statistics, for every single steel direct employee, there is a multiplier effect to the tune of 8 to 10. So if we are employing 4,000 people at this location, you can imagine 40,000 people have been employed, directly or indirectly. Plus, when the revenue generation happens in Gujarat, the taxes, the excise duty, and so on and so forth, various indirect taxes, and other benefits which accrue to the state that is going to happen.